Today we're just going to be looking at how we can get a widget in Python Tkinter to hide or unhide itself when a variable or potentially a text box is empty if it's devoid of any text. Here we have the whole piece of code. It's fairly simple. We just import Tkinter. We create two functions, which I'll come back to in a moment. Make the roots, make a couple of variables, and well, for the rest, I'll just show you. We have here a button to hide and unhide the label. We have a text box, and we have a place here where it prints the text that you put into this text box. Set here with the button, the label, and the entry. And this label here is the one which prints the text here. Now, how does this work? How do we do this? How do we get it to hide and unhide on command? Well, it's pretty simple when you figure it out. The two functions, one of them is for the text box, the other is for if the entry is empty. Now, we're using also a trace here so that we can pass information to the name update. The name update is triggered whenever we change the entry with the validate commands fNameUpdate, which triggers this. So what happens is when you put any text into the entry, it starts the updateName function. And if the variable which the entry is changing, if that variable is equal to nothing, you know, no text, it removes the grid location of the label we're using to print the text. Otherwise, if it says anything else, as in if there is text, then it adds the grid. So here, when there is no text, it does a grid remove and removes it. Else, if there is text, it adds it back. And of course, we have the button here, which does a pretty similar thing. We have a Boolean variable for widgets shown. Every time you click the button, it starts the toggle text box function. And if the widget is shown, if that's true, it again uses grid remove to hide it, to remove it, and then sets widget shown to not itself. Although I just noticed we can even optimize this slightly by removing the line here and removing the line here and putting it here. So now it'll run if it's true, else if it's false, and then either way, whether it's true or false, it's going to set it to not itself. So if it's true, it becomes false. If it's false, it becomes true. So if it's true, it again will remove it from the grid, will remove the label from the grid. If it's false, it will add the label and make it true. But a couple of other things that you might like to do. One, for instance, when you first start this, you can see that it is labeled. It is here. There is space for the text to be. But when you first start it up, there is no text there. So perhaps you want to start it out with this space being removed, with it not being labeled in the grid. Well, we can do this pretty easily. We can just go to the place where we assign the label at a grid location and remove it. Now what happens is when we start it up, it's not there and there's no space for it to be there. But as soon as we put text in, it creates it. If we want it to have a specific location, such as this, we can just copy the grid location specified previously and stick it into here, where the label is re-added by the updateName function, and again into here, where it's re-added through the toggle text box function, which simply means that the grid location is specified within the functions rather than where we first define the label. The other thing you might want to do, let's say that if your text box is empty, we also want the button to hide, not just the label. Well, this is also pretty simple to do. We do the same method. First of all, we have to put the grid away. We'll just remove this from here. The button won't have a place to be. And it also means it won't appear at all because we haven't put it back in yet. We haven't created another way of adding it to the grid. And we can go here within the function for updating the name, for checking if there's any text there. And just use button toggle, and then a dot, and the same grid location command that we took from over here. So we also need to add the button being removed here, where we remove the label, from checking the entry for if there's any text in there, again with the button toggle dot grid remove. And now if we run it again, We can see it's empty. It's empty from the start. There's no button. There's no text box. As soon as we start typing in text, the button functions to hide and unhide this text. The other widgets move in and out to properly align themselves with what's available in the screen. And when we remove the text again, it all disappears back. This is just a useful little way I found of potentially streamlining your UI, since sometimes you don't want every command to be available. In the example here, we change it using an entry to remove and add these widgets, but of course this can be done by any method that involves firing a function. Of course it's up to you to find how to implement this and how to use it, but this is the knowledge. That's all for now.